That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May.
That's life. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. Break it down to him, Frankie. Yeah, that's how it is. It's just the way things are, unfortunately. But good evening. How are you? My name is George Mason. I'm going to talk to you tonight about religion. I'm just going to scratch the surface, not going to get deep or heavy. It's just that I just, you know, want to touch on certain little things that I find as a problem with religion. There's almost 4,200 religions throughout the world. That right there is a problem, because there's just so many different points of view, so many different ideologies and the way people look at things. And, you know, it only leads to confusion, because there's no definitive exactly, you know, what's what, who's right. Is everybody right? Has everybody had that answer that we're searching for, that we're seeking? I don't know. I don't think 100% that you can say that this is the right way or that's the right way. You know, what works for you, that's what's right. What you believe in, that's what's right. Now, is that the truth that you're seeking? I don't know. 4,200 different religions, and you have different books. When I say different books, I'm talking about the Christian Bible. You have 66 books in that Bible. You have the Catholic Bible, the Catholicism, has 73 books. You have 46 in the Old Testament and 27 of the New, which constitutes the 73 books in that Bible, in the Catholic Bible. And you have the Jewish Bible, right? Well, the Torah, the what we call the law, the five books from Moses, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Those are the five of the Torah. And then going back to the 66 books of the Christian Bible, we have 39 Old Testament and 27 of the New Testament. And you know what's interesting about the Bible is that so many different interpretations. You could have 10 people read one scripture and come up with 10 different interpretations. So is it cut and dry? Is it clear? How could it be when everybody is looking at it from their perspective and they're drawing on what they feel that is, that they're seeing and that they're looking at? When I really started to study the Bible and to read the word, a West Indian brother had invited me to his church. I guess he was working at a store, you know, selling beef patties and rollies and stuff. And I walked in and he gave me a pamphlet. And I guess he maybe didn't think I was going to take him. I did. And I started going to church with him. And his pastor, his cousin was pastor. So I loved it. I loved the fellowship. And they took the Sabbath on a Saturday. And that was okay, you know. And I learned a lot. And I really, you know, fell in love more so with the word than I was previously. And I was already reading, but not on a continuous basis. The thing is, he told me, he said, "Brother George, you have any problems, you give me a call, anything." And I said, "All right, you know, I will." And I didn't even get out of Genesis when I called him. Maybe at the first, when I said, "Brother Dwight," he said, "George," he said, "how are you?" I said, "I'm good, but I got a problem, I'm stuck." He said, "What's wrong?" I said, "Listen, I'm in Genesis. You told me to give you a call if I have any questions, any problem." I said, "But there's a passage here that says Cain knew his wife." I said, "Who?" He said, "Me soon call you back, brother." That was 12 years ago. I haven't heard from him yet. He couldn't answer it because, you know, I mean, it would make sense that it was his sister, Cain's sister, but he didn't have the answer. And he was going to church for years. As I said, his cousin was the pastor. He couldn't come back with anything that would make any rational or logical sense, that, you know, made any sense at all. So he just left that alone. So, and again, I was reading other passages where it said Enoch and five, again in Genesis 5:24, Enoch walked with God and he was not, for God took him. And I broke that down. I used to study with the Jehovah's Witnesses. They used to come here Wednesday and we fellowship along while I was still going to the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And I told the brother, I said, you know, Enoch walked with God. Isn't that something that you would want to know? Isn't that a glorious something that, you know, he walked with God? You know, where is that? Why is that not in the book? They couldn't explain to me, you know, with any logical, rational sense, though, why that passage wasn't in there. I mean, why that book, the book of Enoch, you know, but I had got hold of that. I read it and it's an incredible piece. It's an incredible work. I read the Quran and the American Heritage Bible along with the King James. And it's just some of the wording in the King James and the American Heritage is the same, but it's just worded just a little bit differently. And I read some of the Sumerian text, and it's interesting, very, very interesting. I'm seeking, you know, to be led towards the path of righteousness, towards truth. I pray to the Most High Jehovah God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, you know, and that's my God. You know, there's a lot of gods and goddesses throughout the universe. And creation stories, different creation, India, Tibet. Everybody has a creation story. And what came first, right? The chicken or the egg. And some of these stories like reads almost like science fiction. Because it's mind-boggling. I go to a site where it's called The Truth is Scary. And it's a hell of a very insightful site. But the thing is, when you read, you have to keep an open mind. And even with the Word, with the Bible, you want to cross-reference because you might not understand what you're reading to absorb certain passages and scriptures. And it might take you want to maybe come back. That's what I do. I read, I'll come back to it. I'll read maybe a few weeks and then come back to it again to try to absorb it. Like if you're reading what Paul wrote, he has 13 books, very difficult to understand Brother Paul because he's very philosophical. He deals with a lot of like almost legalese. It reads like a legal brief to some extent. It's some of it very convoluted, very intelligent and stuff. But to me, it's not, they say every word in it is inspiration. And I don't believe in that. I don't believe that every word was under inspiration. I got into a heated argument debate with some of the witnesses. They didn't like me doubting Brother Paul's words or, you know, Pearl. I just wasn't feeling it and not feeling him at all. you know, especially with, you know, he was in prison a lot. And as I said, I don't really want to get into it and go into that. Not now. Leave me a comment, like, subscribe. I'll have more definitely topics, controversial, if you will. Religion is always one of those subjects, along with politics is another one, you know, because throughout the world, like I said, there's 4,200 different religions, maybe more. Then you have the atheists, people who don't believe in a God at all, never mind goddess, but they don't believe in God, period. You have agnostic believers, and actually they don't believe, they want to be proven one way or the other. They want you to prove that there is a God or to disprove that there isn't a God, you know? So either way, prove or disprove, but they feel humans don't have the knowledge or the ability to do that, to prove one way or the other that there is a God or that there isn't a God. That's an agnostic, from my understanding. And again, I can only give you perspective from my point of view, from my understanding, and most people, that's how they deal. They operate from their point of view, from what they know, from what they've experienced, from what they've read. And I don't give advice as far as to what you should do. I say what you need to do in order, you know, cross-reference and stuff like that. Or yeah, well, maybe what you should do along those lines, but I don't say do it definitively. You know, that advice I don't give. I would never give. Thank you for tuning in to my channel. Read, stay learned. Hopefully we get through this this pandemic, this crazy times that we're in. And stay in the Word. Keep God in your heart. And prayer to God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Most High Jehovah God. And all the best to you. May God be unto you. May peace be unto you as well. All blessings do.
But I know I'm gonna change that tune.
Breaks down,
when
Frankie.
I'm back on top.
Let them know,
back
Frank.
On top of June.
I'm back on top of June, baby.
I said that's life.
That's life. You got that right, Bobby.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get
they
their
do what?
Stomping on the dream.
You got it.
But I don't let it get me down.